Good evening, everyone, and I'm really delighted to welcome you to our live virtual workshop today, which will be delivered by the PE department. But before I pass it on to the PE team, I'd just like to remind you of some of the key open events that we have calendarized over the course of the next few weeks. Miss, if you can go over to the next slide, please. So in terms of the transition program at Bexley Heath Academy, we've had a series of open mornings. And if you are yet to book an open morning visit to the school, I would really recommend this. It is an opportunity to really see the school in action. So you'll be able to see the facilities, observe the learning environment, also speak to staff across different subject areas. And we've got tours that have already started and they will run until the end of this half term, so Friday 20th of October. So if you've not yet booked a tour, please make sure that you do so over the course of the next 2 weeks. So in terms of our live virtual workshops, we will kickstart today with the PE WOW coaching. And this will really be an opportunity to see some of the remarkable sports coaching that happens across our PE faculty. Next week, next Wednesday, 11th of October, again, I'm really excited to welcome you to the Wacky Science Workshop, which will showcase some of the remarkable experiments that happen across all three sciences. And then the last week of term, Thursday, 19th of October, we will have a horrible history workshop, which will showcase some of the remarkable experiences and events that have happened across history and is part of the history curriculum. And finally, over the half term, there will also be an opportunity to pose questions directly to the principal, which will hopefully inform your decisions as you look to apply for secondary school for your child. So now I will pass you over to Mr. Sheehan and the PE team. Over to you, sir.
Slido available, and if you have any questions or anything you'd like to ask about PE, please do put your questions into the Slido and we'll do our very best to answer them for you as and when we see them. So yeah, like I said, welcome to the PE department. We have Mr. Hills, Mr. Penny and myself here. We are obviously half the PE team. We also have Mrs. Presley, Mrs. Goodridge and Miss Stuffy, who are also part of our team. Unfortunately, they weren't able to be with us this evening. But not to worry, you'll get to meet them as you walk around the school. And if you come here in September, you'll be doing your PE lessons with them as well. So just to introduce PE to you, from year 7 to year 9, you will have 2 PE lessons a week. Those PE lessons are 80 minutes long. One of those PE lessons is your WOW lesson. WOW stands for Workout of the Week. Obviously, we like to think all of our lessons are WOW lessons, but the WOW does stand for Workout of the Week, and that is one of the lessons. Within that lesson, you will learn some science, reasons why we do them, reasons why you need to keep healthy. And also part of the science you learn is there so that if you choose to take sports studies in year 10 or 11, and then again in year 12 and 13, what you are taught in these WOW lessons, hopefully you'll sit in a lesson, oh, I remember doing that, and that will give you a little bit of a kickstart before you do the work there. And then the second lesson of the week is your sports lesson. And what we try to do is from year 7 to 9, we try to give you 16 different sports that you would experience. You do each sport for half a term. Our reason behind that is that not everybody's a football player, not everybody's a rugby player, not everybody's a netball player. And you might come across a new sport you haven't tried, for example, handball. And you might actually think, wow, this is a great game. And you might want to get involved and you might want to take that sport up. Over the last 5 or 6 years, we've actually had 3 players who have been scouted for England development with handball. So you can see the opportunities you get there by introducing you to all these different sports. And then in the summertime, we change for the summer sports. And again, we look at sports like tennis, cricket, rounders, softball, and of course, athletics. So that's how it works in your curriculum time. And then we also like to offer quite a large extracurricular program. We do extracurricular activities in football for both boys and girls. Those are run as separate teams, although we have had girls playing for our boys team. We don't have any problems with that. If they deserve to be there on merit, then we're more than happy to play them in that team. And then we do rugby. Again, we do run rugby training for boys and girls. We do that in conjunction with Dartfordians Rugby Club. And we also run netball. And again, netball, boys can attend netball and play netball. We have no issue with that. The reason we focus on those 3 sports is because obviously we play other schools in the borough in those sports. So we want to make sure that we are the best we can be. And it's also a fantastic opportunity for the students to meet up with their mates who went to other schools and interact with them. And then in the summer, we run cricket, rounders and athletics clubs. Again, so that we can go off to the junior champs and take part in those, and so that we can play other schools in the cricket. At the moment, the cricket is not hardball cricket. It's called softball cricket, because it's done with a wimble, but it's actually a much better form of the game. Sorry to any hardcore cricket people out there, but it is a much better form of the game. It's not as elitist, and it allows everybody to take part. So that's where we like to go with our cricket. So that's a little bit about the curriculum. We also have other clubs that are run. So for those of you who ever attended Athena Gymnastics at Betsy's Academy, we work very closely with Caroline, who runs Athena. She has taken over one of our gyms with all her equipment. And the beauty of that is that we get this fantastic gymnastics suite to do our gymnastics lessons in. And then she also comes and runs a gymnastics club for me once a week. All of our clubs are free. So if it's run by Caroline, she does it as a favour to me. If it's the clubs we run, they're all free and available to everybody, because all we want to do in PE is to educate students on why it's important to stay healthy and encourage them to have a healthy lifestyle. PE kit wise, you'll find out about the PE kit. We do have a school PE kit that we ask the students to wear. We find this is fantastic because it cuts down on any issues about what people are wearing. They all look the same. Obviously, for lessons, we then put them in their bibs that they need and they get on with it. So please do pay close attention to what is required for PE. And we do ask as well that when students are injured for PE, we know we're not qualified doctors. That's absolutely fine. But we do ask that students bring PE kit in with them. Our reasoning behind that is this is England. The weather's not that great. And if the students are due to go out to Goals for their lesson and halfway through the heavens open, and obviously the students out there will get wet. If they're in their school uniform, they're then wet for the rest of the day. Whereas if they have their PE kit on, they've got a nice warm school uniform waiting for them when they get inside so they can get changed. But as long as students attend school with their PE kit and medical notes, then obviously we take that into consideration when they are doing PE. So that's a little bit about our PE curriculum. As I said, we have our gymnastics suite for one of our halls. This hall we're in right now is more of our table tennis and WOW hall. We've got our big sports hall that we use, and of course we have the use of Goals from 8 in the morning till 5 o'clock in the evening. So that's a fantastic facility for us and our field. So if you've got any questions, anything you'd like to know about the PE curriculum, please do feel free to put them into the Slido and we will get back to you and answer those as soon as we can. A question I often get asked, is PE mixed? No, PE is not mixed. In year 7 to 9, boys do PE, girls do PE. Often what we've done this year is, because we've got 2 classes per band, what the first lesson, for example, the boys might do the WOW lesson, and then the second lesson they do their sport. So the girls do their sport the first lesson and their WOW the second lesson. When your child gets to year 10 and 11, PE changes slightly. They only get 1 hour of it, or one lesson, 180-minute lesson. And what we do is we give them options. So I will assign 3 areas. So for example, I might say you've got Goals, you've got this, which we call the drama hall, or our sports hall, and we'll say on goals you're doing football in the sports hall, you're doing volleyball in the drama hall, you're doing table tennis, and the students choose which activity they would like to do for that half term. So we open up a little bit, we give them a little bit more freedom. Hopefully they will have picked up one of the sports that they learned from year 7 to 9, really enjoy it and want to take part in that. And then in the sixth form, we also offer 80 minutes of PE a week, which is optional this year. And of course, we have our Charlton Football Academy that runs in the sixth form. At the moment, it's a boys' academy, but I am working really, really hard with Charlton to try and say, look, let's make a girls' academy here. And at the moment, I've got about 40 year sevens to year nines attending girls' football training. So it's looking very positive that hopefully I can twist Charlton's arm and say, look, there's 40 young ladies here who are desperate to keep playing football. So that's something we're looking at doing in the future. So like I say, hopefully that gives you a good idea about the PE curriculum, what goes on at Bexleyheath Academy. And what we should now do is we shall now move into giving you a typical example of one of our WOW lessons, what goes on, showing you how it works, and getting you to join in. So before I begin it, just to make sure all the movements you're going to do today can be done in a quite a small area. The widest you need is a star jump to go out nice and wide, and then you'll also be sitting down to do sit-ups. So that's the kind of space you need. You don't really need water, okay? A lot of people think, oh, when they're exercising, they need to have water with them. Often we find that more water gets spilt than gets drunk. So don't worry too much about that, and just make sure you are in nice, loose clothing. Any parents and carers out there, we cannot see you. So if you want to join in as well, please feel free. When we do the WOWs with the students, we do encourage them to go home and do them again with their parents or their carers at home. Yeah, sorry about that. But, you know, we think it's a fantastic way. 20 minutes a day to keep fit is absolutely brilliant, and these WOWs are nice and easy. So when we go to the WOW, for all of our lessons, we have what we call an overarching question. So that's a question that runs through the whole of that curriculum. So for football, it might be, what skills do I need in order to be able to win the World Cup? Okay, so that's the overarching question. Then when we get into our lessons, we have individual lesson exploration questions as well. Our overarching question for our WOWs is, why do scientists say that exercise is a natural medicine for the mind and body? So when the students come into our lesson, certainly the first couple of lessons, we'll pose that question to the students and we'll say, you've got 30 seconds to talk about it with the people around you so they can really find out what everybody thinks, and then we'll take feedback from them for it. And often, the obvious one is, well, for the body, it gets you fit. It helps build your muscles. It makes your heart better. We get a lot of answers like that, which is fantastic. And we struggle a bit more when it comes to how does exercise become a medicine for the mind. And everybody knows off the back of COVID and things, there's been mental health has become a really, really, really big thing. And the topic for this week is looking at mental health. And if you can see the board that Mr. Penny's holding here, there's a really badly drawn picture of a mug there. And you'll notice that there's a line halfway through the mug. So if you had to describe that mug to me, let's say I actually had the mug in my hand with a drink in it, and I said to you, describe that mug to me, you would possibly come up with one of two answers. You'd possibly say to me, sir, that mug is half empty. Or you might say, sir, that mug is half full. And that is what we'll be looking at in this WOW, and we'll be looking at how exercise helps the mind. Because for people who look at that and say, well, that mug is half empty, it sounds like you're the kind of person who maybe looks at a situation and thinks, that's a bit tough. I don't think I can deal with that. I don't think I can achieve that. Maybe in a maths lesson, you come across that maths question that is just that little bit too difficult, and actually to try and spend time solving it is just, it just pains my brain too much. I really can't be bothered. So instead of giving it a go and maybe getting the answer right or maybe getting the answer wrong, you just put your pencil down and give up. Or maybe if you're the kind of person who looks at that and says, actually that cup is half full, you're the kind of person who has a very positive outlook on life. And whatever gets thrown at you, you sit there and think, you know what? Okay, I'm going to find a way to defeat that. I'm going to find a way to challenge that. And that is where we want to talk about how exercise helps your mind. Because when you're doing these WOWs, not going to lie to you, once you get through 6 months of doing them, they do get progressively harder, but because you've been doing them regularly, your body's adapted to it. And it's all about when you're facing doing star jumps for a fifth time, do you sit there and go, oh, it's too difficult? Because the mind teaches you very, very quickly that you can't do it. The mind teaches you very, very quickly that it's all too hard. When actually your muscles are there going, what's your problem? I can do another 6 of these. I can do another 8 of these. I can do another 10 of these. And your mind tricks you into saying, no, this is too difficult. I can't be bothered. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to give up. And this is where the wow is very important, because that is also a life skill. So with your attitude towards the wow, saying, well, actually, I'm going to give this a go. Yes, it's hurting, but if I push myself and do 3 more press-ups, if I push myself and do 3 more star jumps, you're having a positive effect on your body. You're having a positive effect on your muscles. You're making your muscles stronger. You're making your muscles fitter. You're making your heart stronger so that it works better. It's going to have a positive effect on you. And obviously, the more you exercise, the more you do these things, the more serotonin that gets released into your brain, which is the natural chemical that makes you feel happy. And it's amazing after how many of these wows. After doing these wows, we see our students red in the face. We see them with a lovely sweaty glow to them, but they're not walking around like that. They've got a big grin on their face, and they actually feel really, really good. And the number of times we've had students say to us, oh, sir, that's unbelievable. This has made me feel so much better. Or when they stopped doing them in year 10, after a few weeks of doing year 10, they kind of say, sir, can we do the wows again? We really enjoyed them. We really missed them because of the positive effect it has on them. All right, so when we ask that question, why do scientists say that exercise is the natural medicine for the body and mind? That is because the more you exercise, the better you are going to feel. The more you exercise, the healthier you're going to be. The more you exercise, the more you're going to be able to do. I always say to the students, I'm in a very fortunate position. I have a granddaughter who is 5 months old. And I look forward to the next few months when I see her growing up. And she comes up and she goes, Grandpa, can you come out in the garden and play ball? And I'm not going to be there going, oh, I'd love to, but my back's gone. Or I'd love to, but I know that I'm going to be able to get out there and I'm going to be able to play and do what she wants to do because of all the exercise we do. So that's just a little bit into one area of the science we might look at to do with the mind. Obviously, other things we look at is muscles. We teach students the names of the muscles, bones, how muscles work, why it's important to keep your heart healthy, and everything along those kind of lines. So that's just a little bit of an example of what we might do at the start of a well. And then we would move on to the workout of the week, which is the next bit. So in the bottom half of the board, you see it. This workout has the term Tabata. So what that means is it's going to be working for a minute 15 times. Okay, so it's a 15-minute workout. But within that minute, you're going to work hard for 45 seconds. And then you're going to get a 15-second break to recover and move into the next exercise. So what we're going to do is we're going to do 3 exercises. We'll take you through them in a minute. We're going to be doing star jumps, okay? We are going to be doing air squats, and we're going to be doing butterfly sit-ups. So those 3 movements. So what will happen is you'll do star jumps for 45 seconds, have a 15-second break. Then you do air squats for 45 seconds, have a 15-second break. Then you do butterfly sit-ups for 45 seconds, have a 15-second break. That is one round. We're going to do that 5 times. It becomes a 15-minute workout. So hopefully you have got everything you need. You've got yourself ready. If you just have a look around you, make sure you've got plenty of space. What you might want to do as well is get a cushion or find something to roll up for when you do the butterfly sit-ups, because this sits nicely in the small of your back and just helps you a little bit with them. And what we have as well tonight for you is we have 3 of our students who have volunteered to come in and help us tonight. One has just been involved in a football match for school. Another one has just been involved with an hour's football training. And I don't know whether what the third one's been doing, but you can see how committed they are. You'll see them coming into view behind us. So these students are going to do the wow with you alongside Mr. Hills and Mr. Penny. All right. But before we do that, we need to take you through we need to take you through the movements. So the first movement is a star jump. Right, so do you want to move that to the side? I can see what is over there. So star jump. Star jump is a simple movement. We like it to start off in a nice, thin, straight position with your hands by your side. And for the star jump, you're going to take your whole body out. Okay, I like you to clamp at the top because it helps with the foot extension and bring yourself back in. All right, so it should be out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in. So if you would just quickly like to do five of those to get yourself into the habit. Are you ready? If these guys will do it with you. Five star jumps, really get those hands nice high. Well done, Jake, good clap there. Get that foot extension at the shoulders. So that would be star jumps for you. A nice, easy start. That was good cardio. Then we move on to air squats. Now the thing about air squats is you've got to get the technique right. So with your air squats, you start with your feet shoulder width apart, right? Not really wide, shoulder width apart. Let me just go this way so you can get out of the way from PET. Sorry, guys. Now, shoulder width apart. What I'm going to do with my feet is I'm going to slightly turn my feet out. Not really far, okay? Just slightly turn them because I don't want my knees coming in as I squat. I want my knees going out. I need to make sure I keep my heels on the ground. And the idea is that my knees and my hips make right angled L shapes. Now, when I do an air squat, sorry, Mr. Heels, I'm going to come right in your face here. When I do an air squat, I like to start my hands behind. I just find that bringing my hands forward helps with the squat. I'm going to move here, otherwise I'm going to end up slapping Mr. Heels. That won't be good. All right, so for an air squat, I start my hands back. You go forward, okay, nice and low. Try and keep your chest up. You can see Mr. Heels prefers his hands out in front. That's fine. And you come back up. But it's about getting the bottom down below your knees and back up. And try and really come back up straight and fully extend. Don't kind of get caught there. We always say this one to the students here and they love it. It's not dad dancing, okay? It's not a little bit of that. Dad at the wedding having a dance, all right? It's a full squat, all the way down, almost knees and elbows almost touch, okay? So if you want to give five of those a go, make sure those toes are pointed out slightly and your knees go out, your knees don't come in, and you keep your heels on the floor. Go for it, kids. Good, nice and low. Almost imagine you're sitting on a chair. Almost imagine there's a chair with a drawing pin on it. You don't really want to sit on it. Just before you're about to sit down, you come up again. So they're your air squats. Now, last but not least, we have butterfly sit-ups. We call them butterfly sit-ups because of the way your legs are placed. So you're going to sit on the floor, please, and your feet, you can see Mr. Heels is better than mine, which Mr. Sheehan and PE team blocks it. You put the soles of your feet together, all right, and you pull your heels towards your belly button, and you start with your hands on your toes. You're going to go all the way and touch the floor behind your head and come up and touch the floor in front of your toes. So if you watch Mr. Heels do it, because he's right in center shot, all right, he goes all the way back and touches. His legs look like butterfly wings. That's why it's called a butterfly sit-up. If you've got the rolled up towel or whatever it is you've used, the cushion, that goes behind you in the small of your back just to give you a bit more support. Okay, it doesn't make the sit-up, it doesn't give you magical power to shoot you back up, all right? It just supports your lower back. So hopefully you've had a chance to give a few of those a go. So if you would like to stand up again, please, we need to do a little bit of a warm-up before we begin so that your heart rate is increased to get oxygen pumping around your muscles. So at this point, I'm going to step out being the old man of the crew, and Mr. Penny's going to be my substitute and step in. So if we can just start off by doing 10 star jumps, please. Off you go. Fantastic. And then we're going to do what are known as spotty dogs. So my left leg's going to be back with my left arm, my right leg forward, my right arm, and you just swap. And I say that is one. Otherwise, it's going to be an odd number. So you can either do 10 or 20, whichever way you count. Go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, and then let's just do five air squats, please. Go. One, five air squats. Fantastic. Okay, good. So that should get your heart pumping and moving. And then just to get a few mobility exercises going, we're going to do a warm-up which involves a lunge and moving our arms up. So as you lunge forward, move the arms up. As you step back, bring them down. Okay? So a nice step forward and bring the arms down as you step back. Go for it.
10?
Yeah, 10 of those, please. Yeah.
Take your time.
Take your time with these. These are your stretching, okay? So dynamic stretching, just to get the muscles moving a bit, to get the synovial fluid moving around, to warm the joints up. All right, so have a good stretch when you do it. Fantastic. Try not to smash the knee into the ground. Just take your knee down so that it almost touches the floor. Okay, so hopefully we are ready to begin. So if you'd like to get yourself in position, at the front here, you can see a clock. All right, hopefully this is going to work. It's going to count down. You'll see it counted down from 45, telling you to rest, and then it will give you 15 seconds rest.
Is that says 10 seconds before it starts?
No, I know, it's right. So what happened is Mr. Hills is just jumped out for a second to start a timer. You'll also hear a timer through the speaker. There'll be music playing. It will count down from 10 seconds. It will go beep, beep, beep. And after that third beep, you begin. All right? So, Mr. Hills, are you ready?
I am.
Let's go, please.
Well, 10-second countdown starting now.
The 10-second countdown is beginning.
And we are starting in 4, 3.
Okay, star jumps. Get those arms as high as you can. Really get the shoulder joint opened up. However many you do now, you're going to try and do every round. Keep going. 20 seconds left. Keep going. You can see the floor. Nice arm, nice arm, good. You should be resting and getting ready to do air squats. Air squats next. Get those heels down. Make sure your knees get up sideways. Slowly forward. Nice step. Right then. Going. Good. Remember, you are trying to do the same number each round. Don't kill yourselves. Get a nice pace going that you can keep up. You've got 10 seconds. Can you get 5 more in? 10 seconds. 5 more to get in. Come on. You've got this. Good, that hurts. And rest. Well done. Okay. Get ready for battle slide pickup. If you've got that support and you want it, put it behind your lower back. That's the front. 5. Run. Go. Can you get 20 sit-ups in 45 seconds? Can you make 20? Can you do 15? Come on! What have you got? Well done, Jess! Keep going! You're halfway there! Come on! 15! 15! Don't give up! Don't let your brain tell you to give up! Push through it! Come on! Your muscles have got plenty left in you!
Let's keep going. Vision change, mates. 60 minutes. Have a rest. Well done. That's one round done. Four rounds to go. We go back to star jumps. Three, two, one, let's go! Remember, you're trying to do the same number as round one, if not beat it. Your target is the same number. Do not do less than round one. Come on, that is your target. Push yourselves, push hard. Keep going, the music should carry on. Keep going.
Don't lose the ball. Come on. 21,
Top of the leg, there's four of them. Okay, so Mr. Penny and all of them, you bring your heel to your bottom, you try and keep your knees together, and you push your hips forward to really stretch. And what we're going to do is we're going to do this for 15 seconds. So we're going to do it like we're doing the lesson. I'm going to count the odd numbers, you guys are going to count the even numbers. One,
two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten,
11,
12,
13,
14,
15. Change over. Legs, swap legs. You can now see Mr. Hills is relying on Mr. Bennett to keep his balance. I don't blame him. If you need help, hold the wall, hold the shoulder of the person next door to you. Jay, try keep the knees together, please. One,
two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten,
11, 12, 13, 15. Give a good shake of both legs. Give a good shake out. We're now going to move to there. Hold again to the gastrocnemius at the back of the legs. So you'll have noticed everybody has taken up a position where they step forward. Don't do a massive step, but step forward and push the heel of the foot at the back towards the ground. Both feet should be facing forwards, and you should feel this stretch in the back of the leg that is furthest behind you. That is your gastrocnemius or your calf muscle. One,
two, three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
10,
11,
12,
13,
14, 15. It's really important you keep that heel pushed to the ground. Good. Change over legs. Set yourselves up. Try and keep your body upright. One,
two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
10,
11,
12,
13,
14,
15. Okay, so we've done quads, we've done gastrocnemius, let's do hamstrings, which are found behind the knee at the top. So for this activity, what you do is you put step forward with one leg, the leg that steps forward you keep straight, you point your toes towards the ceiling, you bend your other leg and slowly lower your bottom down until you feel it pulling behind your hamstring. It will harm, that means you're extending the muscle. One,
two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
10,
11,
12,
13,
14,
15. Swap legs.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and have a good shape of your legs. Well done, ladies and gentlemen. There is a chance that when you wake up tomorrow, you are going to ache. You do not need to ring 999. You do not need to run to the doctors. Okay, that is because you have worked your muscles and you might well have done something which is good for them called micro tears, and you are now repairing your muscles and building them up. The best thing you can do tomorrow is get up, go to school. Run around at school, do PE lessons if you've got PE lessons. Run around the playground, play football, whatever it is you do, and just keep moving and get those muscles moving. If they really hurt, we've shown you, or these guys have shown you, three stretches you can do to stretch them out. Other things you can do, grab a tennis ball and rub the sore area with it. If whoever you live with owns a massage gun, okay, with their permission, don't just go and take it and use it. With their permission, you can always use that as well, but that's a little bit extreme. There are also rollers if you've got them at home. But like I say, a tennis ball is fantastic just to roll around the muscles to remove any lactic acid that's built up. Expect to be in pain, particularly in your abdominal regions, if you're not used to doing sit-ups. It is not a bad thing. It is a good thing. So, well done for doing that today. I do hope you've enjoyed it. That is something you can do on your own. Like I say, 15 to 20 minutes a day. You don't need all the smart gadgets like we've got to do it with. You just need a stopwatch. If you've got an Android phone or an iPhone, you can download an app, smart one, which does a timer for you. But that is the kind of thing you can do once, twice, three times, five times a week if you want, and that'll help improve your fitness. I've just realized I don't think any of us actually logged on to the Slido, so maybe if Mr. Chowdhury could put the Slido code back up, I'll see if I can scan it to see if there are any questions. Otherwise, whilst you recover, I'll let this fantastic team behind me recover. A massive round of applause to you and to these guys for their hard work. Thank you. You may go, my team, and I'll hang around to see if there are any questions, if Mr. Chowdhury's heard of anything. I'm sure he'll let me know. Thank you. Well done. Take care. And like I say, I'll be around to answer anything. I'm just going to get the Slido now. Okay, excuse me. I'll just put that on. And give me a second, please. Find me camera on my phone. There it is. Let's see if I can get this now. Right. I think I'm on. Apologies for not answering questions sooner. Here we go. Let's see if there's any questions on here. There are no questions asked yet. Wow. So obviously I have managed to explain it all really well. That's first time for everything, eh? Fantastic. Okay. Over to you, Mr. Chowdhury. You're on mute, sir.
Thank you so much again to Mr. Sheehan, the PE team, and to our students. And we hope that you've really enjoyed the WOW workout. And I'm really looking forward to welcoming you to our next live virtual workshop session, which will be the Wacky Science Workshop on Wednesday, 11th of October, which is next week. And this will be an opportunity to showcase some of the remarkable experiments that take place in our Key Stage 3 curriculum, but also just a reminder of some of our other transition program events. So we've got the open morning session, which will be running right up until Friday 20th of October, which is the last day before the October half term. If you've yet to book a visit, please make sure that you do so, because it's a great opportunity to see the school in action, see all the facilities, observe the learning environment, as well as speak to and the teachers across all the different subject areas. And you can book that from 9 to 1pm through the course of the next 2 weeks. There will also be a horrible history workshop on Thursday, 19th of October. And then finally, an SLT question and answer session where you have the opportunity to ask any questions that you might still have to Ms. Lutfer, who is the principal. And that date will be confirmed and it will be put on the school website. All the links for the live virtual workshops will also be on the school website, where you'll be able to access those workshops. I look forward to seeing you all next week on the Wednesday for the Wacky Science Workshop. Until then, take care. Bye now.
Bye.